or the child may have of a rabbit, it doesn't necessarily mean you have the right to have the fear for it, but it's a secondary, a different type of fear. So Allah says, وَيَخْشَوْنَ رَبِّهِمْ مِنْ عُذَمَاتِهِ. They know the place of Allah, so they give them a right type of fear. وَيَخَافُونَ. And they're afraid of an evil return. وَالَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا بِتِغَاءَ وَجْهِ رَبِّهِمْ. And those people who are patient, and a patient is in the time that it happens. Okay? They are patient, and patience is called complaining to Allah as the only one that can change that situation. When something happens, when they're tested, not because they're afraid of that thing, but because they are wanting the face of Allah. They want the pleasure. They're doing it to please Allah. وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ. And they established the salah. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ أُقْبَدَّارِ. These are the ones that are going to have أُقْبَدَّارِ. So if you say, what is أُقْبَدَّارِ? What is this last place of return? Allah says, أَطْفَ الْبَيَانِ. He says, clarifying it. And أَطْفَ الْبَيَانِ here is, I said, I saw your brother. Which brother? Muhammad. Okay? So Allah says they have Uqbuddar. What is Uqbuddar? Allah says, Jannatu Adn, the gardens of Eden. That's what he says right there. Yadukhulunaha, that you'll be entering it. And everyone, man salaha, and everybody from that is righteous, from abaihim, from their parents, wa azwajihim, and their wives, wa dhurriyatihim, and their offspring. This is another reason why I say that the people here in America, the children in America, the African Americans and the whites and the Spaniards that have accepted Islam after not having no da'wah program here in America, from the du'a of their great grandparents who died in slavery or were taken from them in Africa, because Allah says in وَمَنْ صَلَحَ مِنْ أَبَاهِمْ وَأَزْوَاجِهِمْ وَذُرِّيَّاتِهِمْ, and their offspring. And we see that happen in Surah Al-Kahf when those children who had owned that wool, and they got that. It wasn't their father that was an orphan. It was their great-grandfather who made dua for his offspring, and so they got the barakah of it. So then it goes on to say, وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يَدْخُلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ بَابٍ. And the angels enter upon them from every door. What are they saying to them? سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِمَا صَبَرْتُمْ. سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ. May the source of peace and perfection be upon you. Why? بِمَا صَبَرْتُمْ. Because you were patient. Showing the place. Out of everything that Allah mentioned, Allah chose to say that the angels came in and said, Bima sabartum, because you were patient, showing us that how much patience is important in our lives here. We so much to jump off the handle. We're never patient. We're always scared. All this anxiety. Bima sabartum, and patience is in the time when it happens. Patience isn't like being tied to a chair waiting to get beat and you're struggling trying to get out. You say, I was patient. No. Patience ain't sitting around not doing anything. Patience is complaining to Allah. That's what patience. If you want to know patience, read the story of Ya'qub. Read the story of Ayyub. This is patience. Not uttering a word that will displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And complaining to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only one that can change the situation. So, فَنِعْمَ أُقْبَدَّارِ. So, a best place. Well, contrastly, he says, وَالَّذِينَ يَنْقُدُونَ عَهْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مِيثَاقِهِ وَيَقْطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَنْ يُوصِلَ وَيُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Allah says, in the contrast to that, those who break the contract that they have, and they don't join what Allah has told them to join, these people, and they make mischief, and they do evil in the earth. These people, أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ اللَّعْنَةِ. These people upon them is the curse. Is a curse. And a la'na from Allah is ibad min rahmatihi. It's to be far, you know, a curse from Allah is to be far away from Allah. To be far away from His mercy. Anything tied to Allah is a barakah. If you say Baytullah, the house of Allah, you want to be in that house. That house has barakah. But if it's far from Allah, then that thing is a cursed thing. Okay? It says, وَلَهُمْ سُوءُ الدَّارِ. And these people have an evil place to return to. And I'm going to stop here. Actually, I'll do this last ayah. It says, اللَّهُ يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. Again, contrastingly, Allah says, Allah is the one who gives and extends to people, his rizq. What? لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَقْدِرُ. And he refuses to hold. Allah gives and he withholds. Okay? And he says, وَفَرِحُوا بِالْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. And they're all pleased with hayatu dunya. وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا بِالْآفِ الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا مَتَاعَ. And the hayatu dunya, they're pleased with this life of the world, but the life of this world compared to the hereafter is nothing but mata'. Mata' is something that you need, but you don't need it that much. It is what they call a cheap thrill, some short-lived fun. So I akulu kauli hadha, I say this, and I say again, read Surah Turaj. It is a surah of contrast, examples. If you want to know more about it, you got to read it yourselves. Inshallah ta'ala, I'll print out a form explaining the whole surah just in general. How many ayah does it have?
43.
We did 30-something, okay?
26.
26. We did 26. We're halfway there with this surah. And so hopefully, inshallah, you get the example why it's a surah of contrasting things. Aqulu qawli hadha, astaghfiru li wa lakum, wassalamu alaykum.